That might look like a statistic, but remember that it took the United Kingdom 150 years to do the same thing during its industrial revolution. The continent is now finding its feet and has immense potential. The factors behind this new dynamism were a combination of sound macroeconomic policies, debt reduction initiatives, strong international demand for commodities, demographic dynamics, including fast urbanization, the advent of the mobile telephone, lowering costs of doing business and service and the service delivery, and a general positive reassessment of the Africa risk due to improving governance and the politics. Well, the world has been watching over the Africa story of recent. In May 2000, The Economist cover page was entitled Hopeless Africa. But on the 3rd December 2011, the same magazine pointed to the hopeful continent. And in September this year, Foreign Affairs magazine published an article on Africa's turn. Whether it is hopeful continent or Africa's turn, what is clear is that Africa is on the move, and you better watch out where your money is now being invested. The typical case is Rwanda, which has maintained a GDP growth of 8% over the last decade. It is the best global reformer and the second easiest country to do business in Africa, according to the World Bank Doing Business Report. As highlighted by the Director General of the Arab Fund for Economic and Social Development during the recent Arab-Africa Economic Forum, the Africa continent holds about 10% of the proven world oil reserves, and discoveries are increasing every year. It also has about 10% of world reserves of water, about 8% of gas reserves, and about 6% of the coal reserves, in addition to uranium, gold, and other metals, fertile agricultural land, and huge wealth of forests and livestock. Moreover, current African population of 1.1 billion, compared to 270 million at the time of independence, is expected to reach 2.4 billion by 2050, hence creating the largest market globally. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, Asia's economic links with Africa, which has a long history, have increased dramatically over the last 5 years. Asia's emergence as the world's fastest growing market presents opportunities and some inspiration for Africa, but also challenges. One such opportunity lies in the lessons we can draw from Asia. Asia forged its own path of development using its own model of growth. Today is one more occasion to exchange experiences and enhance partnership. We can learn how so many countries in Asia have been able to graduate so early from aid dependency, recover so quickly from the 1997 financial crisis, and to join the leaders in the global growth league. We can learn about how we open up our economies, encourage private sector growth, and new sources of capital, as sustainable growth in Africa can only be achieved through promoting a vibrant private sector so as to reduce its dependence on aid, trading our way to development, as was done in the countries of Asia. The partnerships we have to forge and develop are embedded in the lessons we can learn from Asian economic development and the challenges Africa is facing today. I will just list only a few of them. The first is partnership around investment in infrastructure to reduce the cost of doing business and increase integration to the global economy. As a continent of 54 countries, internal as well as external connectivity is a priority towards reducing market fragmentation within Africa through continental integration and allowing and facilitating trade with partners. Hence the need for transport corridors, maritime ports that are efficient, railways, airports, and broadband connectivity. The second is partnership around transfer of skills. If you allow, I'll end with a quote from my president, His Excellency Paul Kagame, President of the Republic of Rwanda, at the last Africa Development Bank annual meeting earlier this year. Quote, the private sector must be facilitated to grow further and faster. In recognizing the indispensability of partnership, we have to recognize that the state has a crucial role to play in creating conditions for sustainable growth. increased participation of citizens, and reduction of inequality. Evidence from other parts of the world, like Southeast Asia, has shown that transformation cannot be left to markets alone. The state plays a key role in setting the development agenda, attracting and channeling investment where it has the greatest impact and enabling all sections of society to participate in productive economic activity. End quote. With this quote, distinguished ladies and gentlemen, let me end by saying, long live the partnership between Asia and Africa, and I thank you very, very much for your kind attention.